NFL on EA Sports. A pair of tight ends will be on the field today, looking to do whatever it takes to give their team an advantage. It's the Jaguars going up against the Patriots. Nothing quite like New England in the fall, so let's get you up to the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, we are about an hour's drive southwest of downtown Boston in the area known as Patriot Place, Gillette Stadium, here in Foxborough. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Jacksonville Jaguars and the New England Patriots. Hi again, everybody. Alongside my partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, we saw Larry focus on the tight end matchup in his open. You think it's one to watch, don't you?
Definitely one to watch because these guys can create such big plays by all the different things they can do. Line up out wide, in the slot, line up in a normal tight end position. And then who are you going to cover them with? Is it a linebacker, a defensive back? They create mismatches all throughout the game.
Here's the kicker, Jason Myers, to get this one started. And we are underway in Foxborough. Returnable for Dorsett. And he'll take this across the 25, couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. So now the Patriots getting set to take over on offense. And they're led out by a guy who learned from one of the great ones in his first few years in Tom Brady. This is Jimmy Garoppolo.
When you're a backup to one of the all-time great players, if you don't spend time picking that guy's brain or just watching and observing how he does things to increase your game, then you've wasted that time. I don't think Jimmy Garoppolo is that type of a player. I think those lessons learned have a chance to transmit themselves very well.
Bolden to start the drive. So a good spin move, but not a whole lot to show after as he's taken down. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight. And a lot of the weight of this offense falls on the shoulders of the running back.
That's because the offense knows if they give him any openings, any opportunities, he can turn it into a big play at any time.
And they still need 8 yards for the first here on second down.
Here we go now. 3-19. 3-19.
Now Garoppolo throwing on second. Incomplete. And the starters defensively for Jacksonville. And it's a Jags team that finished 3-13 last year. But on this side of the football, they've got a solid foundation, don't they?
I thought that their defense kept them in a lot of games in 2016. I thought they played really well. And now they've got a young core of guys. Remember Jalen Ramsey drafted last year. He made the all-rookie team. Yannick Ngakoue, a really promising outside linebacker, one of the best speed rushers in the game. He's going to be back with them. They need Miles Jack to make a jump, the youngster out of UCLA. But I like, all in all the core players that they have defensively.
He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And a pretty little juke move there on a nice game. Give him 7 on the play, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Obviously, they didn't get everything they wanted on that completion, but they put themselves in a spot where you've got to at least think about going for it. I know where we are on the field, but still, you've got to think about it, don't you?
On fourth down, on now is the lefty Ryan Allen to punt. Play on special teams here. This is going to be down inside the 5, all the way down at the 2-yard line. And not great starting field position here for the offense. They come out here in the eye. On the give, It's the fullback, Mahaner. And he'll get this up past the 5 to the 7-yard line. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
And that run, that changes the whole mentality about the drive right there. They were starting on their own 2-yard line. They just wanted enough space to punt the football successfully. Now they're talking about putting together a drive.
Here we go.
Now back to throw. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he is going to lose yardage here. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And it'll be 3rd and 10 now.
When you lose that kind of yardage on a pass play, you often expect it to be a sack. But that wasn't the case there. They completed the pass. Probably would have been better off just dropping the football and making an incompletion as opposed to catching it and losing that kind of yardage. Extra corner on the field for New England here on third down.
Yeah, another DB. Back to throw now in his own end zone. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. He got 29 yards that time.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-arm guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Fresh set of downs here.
Here we go, here we go. Left 35.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. His throw incomplete. Able to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down.
Ready, right 18.
Again, he'll drop to throw. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
That was not a completion that results in a highlight video. But at the same time, if you have those kind of completions all game long, eventually one of them might turn into a highlight.
The offense in that middle ground here on third down, 3rd and 5.
Let's go now. Right 20.
They'll look to throw again. And incomplete. A disappointing drop there defensively by the rookie. And now 4th down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum. Big play right in his hands. Unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground. So on 4th down, here's Brad Nortman on to punt it away. And this is blocked. The Pats bring heat and they get home. And they are going to take possession of the football. But they will stop him before he gets to the marker, and they will take over after the block punt. And with points at an extreme premium here in a 0-0 game, that could be a big special teams play right there.
That's an advantage play. Someone create an advantage for their team, give them an opportunity, and special teams is usually a terrific starting point for that. Blocking the punt, now they've given themselves a chance, and have seized momentum.
And they'll start this drive with very good field position.
Here we go now.
On 1st down, Garoppolo. Allen's got it over the middle. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up 1st and goal. So an excellent throw and an excellent catch there.
Zone coverage, which means you just have to find the open areas in between defenders, is exactly what happened on that play.
looking to throw. Garoppolo. And this is complete. It's Allen. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice gain right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Hurry up, here we go. Three.
Garoppolo to throw on second down. And it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. Well, your first drive of the first quarter, you get it down there, try to fire it in the end zone, and big-time deflation on that play.
No doubt about it. They're moving and grooving and getting into position, and this is not the ending that they saw on this drive, is it? They had things going their way.
Well, the Jaguars getting set to go, and they'll be looking to avoid what happened last time, which is punting the football.
But when you look at how teams play the game, that complimentary football comes into play. How do I take care of my defense? How do I take care of my offense? Well, the defense is taking care of them in a lot of ways. Now it's time for the offense to jump things up and help their defense out. Give them a little bit of rest.
Yeah, time for them to give them a rest. You took the words right out of my mouth. Here to his running back, and he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
He's quite an eyeful, isn't he? Big, strong, physical guy. When he came out of school and when I looked at my draft board, I went back through my notes to see how I had him rated. The number two back on my board coming out of college. Why? As I mentioned, big, strong, powerful guy, faster than you would think, and has the ability to catch the football out of the backfield, something that we didn't know he truly possessed. We saw that in the offseason workouts. Now he's putting his running ability to good use in the NFL.
Hanning, a quick throw here, that's complete. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
And that's the kind of pass that adds up over time, Brandon. You may not have picked up a first down there, but if you keep chipping away at it, eventually big plays may result.
Immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
That draw play got blown up by the blitz of the defense. Ordinarily, that's exactly what you want. You want them to blitz, and they go past you, and you go past them for a big gain. But in this situation, they hit him at the worst possible spot, right exactly where you were running the draw, and he got in there and got him.
An extra defensive back in the game now here for third and four. Now Henning. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. He will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first.
Set, black 35, black 35.
Go. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's brought down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
I don't want to downplay the run, but that's exactly what I expected out of him coming out of college. When I look back at my draft analysis, one of the highest-rated players on my board, a three-down back who can do everything. And one of the best parts of his game is what he does when he doesn't have the football, because he carries it really well, but he blocks equally as well as pass protects for his quarterback. I think he's going to be special.
Set, right 20.
Now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon. Offense.
Still first down.
throw here out of the gun. Quick hitter here. It's complete. They get the penalty yardage back, plus five more as they get it to second and five.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big-time run, big-time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. They'll come out in the pistol.
Let's go now. Black 35. Black 35.
Now a handoff looking right. And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. He lost two there, and it's third down. They tried to run the counter, just that the defense wasn't fooled.
And when they're not fooled, you see the end result. Because what you're doing there, you mentioned the counter, you're using your offensive linemen sometimes to pull or move to influence the defensive front to go in that direction and create the space back in the other side and block it appropriately. But you're exactly right. Didn't move him. Sat there waiting for him and made the play.
Back to throw here. This is Yeldon on the dump off. No gain at all on the play there. That brings up fourth.
Pass complete, but no gain.
No yards.
Yeah.
So you file that as unsuccessful.
Yeah, you do, don't you? Except on the stats, throwing the ball.
Get a completion.
You get a catch.
Yeah.
But still,
no yardage.
Okay.
So on fourth down, on comes the Jaguars. Jason Myers now for the field goal try. It'll be spotted on the right hash. A 52-yard attempt. And Myers able to knock it through. And the Jaguars grab a 3-0 lead. A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
Myers now converted on the field goal try. Now he's on to kick it away. Now Deion Lewis to return. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Okay, partners, New England comes out here to take the field on offense. This is such an interesting story, how they've been able to do it year after year after year. Guys talk about parity in the NFL. Well, New England has kind of transcended that parity, and they've done it with guys that you don't normally think of as household names.
The parts keep changing for New England. That's the amazing part on offense, all right? Offensive linemen change, receivers change, running backs change. We know the one constant is Tom Brady. Mm-hmm. And that's a huge deal for them. But
now,
to be able to do it in what you call the parity times, and you're exactly right. Everyone's supposed to be pretty equal. New England's still a top 10 offense year in and year out. In 2016, they were number four. And that helped them with the number one ranked defense as well. All right, I'm doing my rudimentary math here. That's his third catch here in the first quarter. I don't know if it's just game plan or he's just finding his way open.
Yeah, maybe a little of both. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground.
All right, here we go. Boom, landing.
Ah! On play action. Now Garoppolo. And he will find his man on the end route. Complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
One of the feature points of the end route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
Leppard! Leppard!
Ah! Here's Bolden. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, we just saw the recipe for success right there. Big body, strong, agile, playing with great leverage and hands. Not really able to be blocked on that play. Close things down inside.
Here we go. Green three.
Now Garoppolo throwing on second. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. Philip Dorsett, the intended receiver. And that'll make it third down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught. Third and 11, five in the secondary now.
Nickel look. Garoppolo looks to throw. Going up top. That's caught inside the 20. A big play there for the Pats on third. 45 yards. Well, last drive he threw the pick, but he's not shy. He's going downfield again there.
And you can't be, because if you back off after throwing an interception, your whole game plan just goes right out the window, and it makes things easier for a defense. And you and I both know there's a quarterback in this league that's any good that doesn't throw an interception occasionally, and they usually bounce back in a big way. I've seen guys throw five and still find a way to win the game in the end.
And now a first down following that long gain. Inside the red zone, it's Garoppolo. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. Only a yard on the pickup there, so it leaves them needing a conversion here on third and a tough nine.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
And defensively, it's a nickel formation here on third down and nine. To throw, it's Garoppolo, and probably the wise decision there. No one open, he just throws it away, and that keeps the field goal on the table as it's fourth down.
Partner, how many times have you heard it? Pressure creates diamonds, right? But it also bursts pipes, and on that one, that's what they got. They got after him, and he was fortunate just to get rid of it.
Yeah, he just had to chuck it away. And Gostkowski's kick is good. And that will tie us at 3-3. So this offensive unit, they've now had three drives, and they only have 3 points to show for it.
Payoff is the key for everything. How many offenses have we talked to that say we have to finish drives? Thus far, this team hasn't finished it quite the way they wanted to.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. Fielded about a yard deep. And now we get our first look at a guy who's been around the block a time or two. He will not be rattled today.
And that changes things for a defensive coordinator, because normally when you get the young guys, you get the rookies, you throw all the exotic blitzes at them and looks they haven't seen. But this guy, he's seen it all.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. Takes it to the 26, just a 1 yard gain. Two Patriots there to bring him down. And the quarterback, he's got some big threats at wideout.
And they seem to get bigger all the time, don't they, Brandon? Every time I look out and watch a game, we're getting these bigger, more athletic, acrobatic receivers. We have some today.
Again, we'll see the pistol here.
Gun, gun, gun!
Here's the option. No, bottled up. Fumble. It's out. It's loose. And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. And he's into the end zone. It's a fumble return and a Patriot touchdown. Huge, huge play by the defense, not only to force the fumble, obviously, but to return it for a touchdown.
And I know it's no fun for anyone who plays offense, but isn't it fun to see how a defense rallies when there's a fumble return and everyone tries to find someone to block and bring it all the way home?
I always like their celebrations because they don't get there that often.
No, they're not choreographed very well usually.
Now Steven Goskowski on for the extra point. And it is up. And it's good. That'll make our score 10-3 now. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for six. So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Here comes the Jaguars offense as they get set to go again. They'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
And the defensive line controls the offensive front the way we just saw there and doesn't allow any of the offensive linemen to leak downfield and get to the linebackers and block them on the second level. You end up with the type of play we just saw. Linebackers didn't have to fight anyone off. Didn't have to knock anyone to the side. Didn't have to elude anyone trying to block them. They just saw the play, ran to the ball, and finished things off.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were. Here's New England defensively. Last year, the number one overall defense as far as points given up goes, and they've got a lot coming back in 2017.
Now they certainly do, and let's go back to the Super Bowl. Trey Flowers, who was their leading sack guy in 2016, had seven in the regular season. He was a monster in the Super Bowl against Atlanta. He's back there for them. How about Dante Hightower, linebacker? His first Pro Bowl in 2016, and then just moving on back to the secondary. Devin McCourty, the guy who quarterbacks him back to safety. He's been to the Pro Bowl as a corner and as a free safety.
Penning, and complete to Lewis over the middle. Well, he's taken down, but not before picking up the first thanks to a flashy little spin move.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there, and how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Let's go now!
And now here's a carry heading left. And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
It's been a struggle this entire game trying to move the ball on the ground. But every now and then, you find a little chink in the armor, and that type of run right there lets them know that they can't stop every single run for almost no gain.
Here we go, here we go. Right 18. Right 18.
Now Henny. Caught right side. It's Lewis. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. A good pickup there at 22.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop it?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve.
Ready, right, 20.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Calling no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down because really they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
And they'll go on the ground. And here's another tackle made at the line. So they're converging well on the football now. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this third down play as we've hit the end of quarter one. 10-3 the score, and we'll return to Foxborough after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Head & Shoulders. Shoulders were made for greatness, not dandruff.
Alongside the former defensive back Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Jaguar football as we begin quarter number two. They're in the midst of a nice drive, but facing a third and long here. Now play number seven of the drive as they're looking at a third and 10. Throw here out of the gun, finding time. His throw caught at about the five. A good pickup there, 26 yards. A nice job there, Charles. They picked up the blitz, were able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz, got him into the right protection scheme, so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get him in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
That's caught at the three. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. James O'Shaughnessy from 4 yards out. And the Jaguars are within an extra point of tying this one up. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. Jason Myers now for the extra point. And he'll put it through, and that evens us up at 10 apiece. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive, and it culminates in a Jags touchdown. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want it to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you've met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants to drive in with a kick other than the extra point. That's it.
They come out here in the eye.
B-19! B-19!
On the handoff, they start with Bolden. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. Crashing in from the end there, not to disrupt the pass game, but to disrupt the run game.
Yeah, I love the distinction, too, because the good defensive ends, they can do it all. Set the edge in the run game, make sure that no one can move it that way, and, of course, rush the passer. On that play, use his speed to get there in the run game.
They'll run again with Bolden, and he'll get only a couple up to the 22.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
So third and seven and an extra defensive back on the field here.
Definitely want to play coverage here.
He's going to look deep down the field. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a fourth down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Here's Ryan Allen now, on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. He juked him. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10. Try and start this drive in the air. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. Let's look ahead for a quick minute. We don't have the schedules yet for next year, but what we do have are the five international games that will be played, four in London and then one again in Mexico, Jacksonville, Baltimore, Miami, New Orleans, Cleveland, Minnesota, Rams, and Arizona. Those in London, and then Mexico's going to get a great game. The Raiders and New England.
Yeah, you're exactly right. And just think about the ones in London. Remember, they're splitting them between the two different stadiums in London, so they get a different flavor in all of these places. But Mexico, for the second straight year, the Raiders are coming to town. That should be a whole lot of fun.
Should be a ton of fun and a very good matchup.
And that's why you see so many teams play a 3-4 defense, because that set gives you a lot of flexibility about where to bring pressure from, and it's hard for an offense to pick it up. Left side, right side, up the middle, especially with some really flexible linebackers.
And with a third and 13 here, the defense in a dime look. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. They do get nine, but it leads to fourth down.
They didn't get the first. first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. Here's Brad Nordman now. And remember, he had his first punt blocked. And that hits at the six and carries into the end zone for a touchback. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. They come out here in the eye. Bolden. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
As a guy carrying the ball, your eyes are going to direct your feet, and you're hoping they carry you to the open spaces. But it's awfully difficult at times because you have so many things you have to look out for. Where's the line blocking? Where's the traffic coming from? Tough to find open spots.
Stay on the ground. Here's Bolden again. And he'll get across the 20, but only to about the 22-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup there, and now they're left with a third and eight.
Well, so far, this game has gone the way the defensive coordinator had hoped. They've dictated things. They've not let them run the ball very well at all. They gave up a nice game there. I doubt it'll back off their confidence. They've played so well throughout this entire game.
A nickel back added defensively as they look to stop this third and eight. They go play action for Lewis. Now Garoppolo. He's got time in the pocket. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays. And you don't get many opportunities to dial them up. And they just did. And they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Fair catch called for and made right at the 25-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the offense will come back onto the field for the first and 10. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Ready, black 35, black 35.
They'll run it now out of the gun. He takes this for 3 to the 29. Two Patriots there to bring him down.
No, that wasn't an explosive run. That wasn't one that took it all the way to the house. But, boy, for a team that's had trouble running it the entire game, that's the kind of run they need, hopefully, to get themselves kick-started.
6 yards here to go for the offense on second down.
Here we go. Here we go. Go, go, go.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Still in search of the first down after that last completion. Here's Bohanna, the fullback. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
And how about that on third down? So many different directions an offense can go. Throw it out wide to the receivers, get it to their speedy running back. They changed up everything and handed it to the fullback, and he surprised them all and picked up a first down.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground.
Ready, right 18.
They'll run the option left. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Second and 10. He's got time. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And they're able to get this one down to the 25.
Now, that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time, that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
When you think of really good teams that play a base 3-4 defense, you'll have to think the defensive line handles a lot of things. Eat up double teams with your nose guard. Your defensive ends are what we call base guys that can hold the point of attack, and they make it very difficult for people to run the football.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Daron Harmon makes the tackle.
But you've got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball, because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
Here's play number 7 on the drive. This is 3rd and 7. 5 receivers in the game, 4 of them to the left side. On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. Surveying the field. And that will be caught. But out of bounds. Out of bounds. Ruled incomplete here. A 3rd down. He tried to stay in bounds. Did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
And Myers able to knock it through, and they will take the lead at 13-10. So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, but the net gain, 3 points.
And you're going to have drives like that in this league. Sometimes you just got to take the 3 and move on. Always better than nothing.
Myers now converted on the field goal try. Now he's on to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So the Patriots coming out now. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Watch it now, Barney!
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here. Garoppolo to throw on second down. And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete. Brandon Bolden that time, the one he was trying to get it to. And it's third down.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well. And he didn't get that done on that play.
So a third and eight.
Set, blue line.
Throwing is Garoppolo on third down. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
Taken in at the 22. A 48-yard punt, 7 on the return. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. Here again comes the captain of this offense leading his crew back out there now. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number 2 here in the second quarter. Now Henning. Wide open receiver complete. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10.
Ready, left 35.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. Takes to midfield, but no further, just a yard there.
And that's the type of play that'll fire up a defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only 1 on that play.
Another pistol look here.
Set, right 18. Right 18.
Now a handoff as they run left side. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much as he's down to the 48.
I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Seven yards remaining here on third down. Is going to be incomplete.
There's so much precision in an offense, especially when you're throwing the ball. And in an out route, plenty of it. How about the quarterback hitting his back foot, balls out of his hands, receiver making his break, making his cut. He's got to time up perfectly. Not always easy to do.
Just let him a little too much.
Yeah, I remember back in the good old days, I was talking to a quarterback, and he said everything they did was on the count system. So when he took a snap, he counted in his head for certain routes, different time frames for each one, and he knew if the ball wasn't out of his hand at that point, he'd better eat it because the play was dead.
The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Hurry up, here we go. Boom, landed.
Garoppolo on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete. That incompletion, Charles, gives me a chance to put you on the clock real quick. NFC teams last year that did not make the playoffs that might make a push this coming year.
Well, three that come to mind right away that we thought were going to be in 2016. Minnesota, remember the start they got off to before that didn't work out so well for them. Arizona, we thought they were a lock to be in the playoffs. In fact, many of us called them Super Bowl contenders. And Carolina, the defending it.
And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked off by Barry Church. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
A one-yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
Now they'll throw here, out of the gun, finding time. Looking left side, he's got it, complete. Only 3 yards on the catch, it's third down. The 37 on third down. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Out of the gun now on third down. He goes underneath for Yeldon. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
The play fake. He'll look to throw. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. A well-designed corner blitz that gets him for a loss of 8 yards.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you